So much new information tonight about that possible Klan confession. Someone close to the investigation says after our report last night, the FBI has launched new interviews about letters allegedly written by Edgar Ray Killen. In those notes, Killen admits his role in the infamous Mississippi burning murders and 32 other cold cases. As 16 WAPT's Terrell Island reports, Killen hopes the same letters can help the KKK.
As far as Edgar Ray Killen is concerned, Mississippi Attorney General Jim Hood is his enemy.
His interest in me started first when he found out that I was fighting the Attorney General office on an appeal for my criminal conviction.
James Stern says in Killen's mind, that made him a friend.
He started telling me some incredible stuff. I realized at that point that at 85 years old at the time when I first met him, he was going to die one day soon. And unfortunately, I says, he can die and take all this to the grave with him, and that'll be a shame. I said, Edgar, I said, do you really want your thoughts to get out there? I says, you got to write this stuff down.
The letter says that Killen wants the Attorney General to put him on house arrest. In his notes to Stern, Killen wrote,
when you leave, this should assure the state giving me medical release, my confession to personally killing Jesse Brown, Vincent Raspberry, Clifton Walker, Ed Smith. There's more I will tell you about.
He says if it doesn't go the way he wants, he'll deny it ever with his writing.
He can deny anything he wants. I'm quite sure at one point, now that we're talking, he's going to deny a lot of things. I mean, come on. It's like he expect me to come out and blow his horn in a positive way, not expose him.
I had a handwriting expert analyze those.
Jerry Mitchell, an investigative reporter with the Clarion Ledger, has reported on Killen since 1989. We compared our letters to older samples of Killen's writing.
Really used an expert for confirmation, but yeah. Just to the naked eye, it looks the same.
Oh, there's his signature right there.
If they are true, Killen's notes could implicate others. There. Killen writes to Stern.
We have talked about many issues of the 1964 case, but Richard Willis, Olin Burridge, Pete Harris, Jimmy Snowden should never be exposed.
There are two suspects that are still alive in this case. Olin Burridge, who owns the property where the three civil rights workers were buried, and Pete Harris. If Edgar Ray Killen were to cooperate and were to testify, then obviously that might give authorities enough information to prosecute that case again, as well as maybe perhaps other cases.
According to these letters, cooperating isn't his motive. He wants to help the KKK by using a black messenger.
I want to change the public image and face of the KKK, and both agree with your intelligence and knowledge, you could become the first imperial wizard as a black man.
He figured he had to take me under his wing so I could be indoctrinated properly to not go against them.
Travel Island, 16, WAPT News.
Stern says he has turned copies of the letters over to the Attorney General's office for review. The AG spokesperson says if Mr. Killen wants to confess his crimes, he'll need for his lawyer to contact our office. We're always interested in information regarding crimes, old and new.